Oh, Bella.
Illumination.
Welcome back to my movie review series. Today, I'll be doing the review on the 2023 Universal and Illumination movie, and this one is the Super Mario Bros. Movie. This is like amazing. Having another video game franchise have their own movie of the mascot of Nintendo. Imagine how became the whole adventure when you play Super Mario Bros. In every Nintendo console. The movie was premiered on April 5th, 2023. The movie is airing on ABC, HBO, and streaming on Peacock, Netflix, HBO Max, Apple TV, and Amazon Prime Video. Now, basically what is the plot of this movie? Italian-American brothers Mario and Luigi have recently opened a plumbing business in Brooklyn, to the derision of their ex-employer Spike and the disapproval of their father. After seeing a significant water main leak on the news, Mario and Luigi go underground to fix it but are sucked into a warp pipe and separated. Mario lands in the Mushroom Kingdom, ruled by Princess Peach, while Luigi arrives in the Dark Lands, ruled by the evil Koopa King Bowser. Bowser seeks to marry Peach and will destroy the Mushroom Kingdom using a superstar if she refuses. He imprisons Luigi to threaten Mario, whom he sees as competition for Peach's love. Mario meets Toad, who takes him to Peach. Peach plans to ally with the primate Kongs to help repel Bowser and allows Mario and Toad to travel with her. She also tells Mario that she ended up in the Mushroom Kingdom as a baby, where the Toads took her in and eventually made her their leader. In the Jungle Kingdom, King Cranky Kong agrees to help if Mario defeats his son, Donkey Kong, in a fight. Despite Donkey Kong's immense strength, Mario defeats him using a cat suit. Mario, Peach, Toad, and the Kongs use carts to drive back to the Mushroom Kingdom, but Bowser's army ambushes them on Rainbow Road. When a blue-shelled Koopa General destroys part of the road in a kamikaze attack, Mario and Donkey Kong plummet to the ocean while the other Kongs are captured. Peach and Toad return to the Mushroom Kingdom and urge the citizens to evacuate. Bowser arrives aboard his flying castle and proposes to Peach, who reluctantly accepts after Bowser's advisor Kamek restrains Toad. Mario and Donkey Kong, having been eaten by a Neo-like Moray, learn they both want the respect of their fathers. They escape the Moray by riding a rocket from Donkey Kong's cart and hurry to Bowser and Peach's wedding. At the wedding ceremony, Bowser intends to execute all of his prisoners in lava and Peach's honor. Toad smuggles an ice flower into Peach's bouquet, which she uses to freeze Bowser. Mario and Donkey Kong arrive and free the prisoners, with Mario using a tanuki suit to save Luigi. Now it's up to Mario, Luigi, Peach, and their allies to take down Bowser and save the Mushroom Kingdom. The story is very well written, as while it can be very easy to guess where the story is going, and there can be a few too many on-the-nose references, the overall plot of the film is very solid, as there is a lot of interesting things going on. There is some very fun action, the humor is mostly very on point, there's a great amount of heart and charm to it, there's a great sense of adventure and wonder, as well as some cool world building, and it does manage to be incredibly faithful to the games with not just its depiction of the world and characters, but also manage to capture the lighthearted and very charming tone of the franchise. Also, a good chunk of the references to not just the franchise but also other Nintendo IPs are pretty neat. The action scenes in this movie are a lot of fun, as they can be very exciting and even kinda intense, like the opening battle between Bowser and the Penguin Kingdom, the duel between Mario and Donkey Kong, the Mario Kart scene, Mario and Donkey Kong's escape from the eel, Mario, Luigi, Peach, and their allies taking on Bowser and his army in the castle, and the final battle where Mario and Luigi battle Bowser in Brooklyn. The movie does manage to have a pretty solid sense of humor, as while there are a few weak jokes, a good chunk of the jokes do land and do get some pretty decent laughs, such as the witty and snarky banter and dialogue between the characters, the gags and visual humor, the dark humor and occasional adult joke, and more. The movie also manages to have a good amount of heart and charm to it, which does give the movie some pretty charming and heartfelt moments, like Mario and Luigi wanting to get the respect of their father, which is something that we find out Donkey Kong also wants. The bond between the titular brothers, and the growing bond between Mario and Peach. The animation is amazingly well crafted, as it does an incredible job at capturing the look and style of the games while also giving it some tweaks, such as the characters all having some great designs that are accompanied by some very fluid and lively movements, the backgrounds and settings being very well crafted and having a great amount of detail and nods to the games. And there are some very well-crafted special effects. This is easily the best animation to come from Illumination so far. The characters are all pretty well written and solid, as while they may be on the simple side, they do manage to be very memorable and likable by having a great amount of chemistry and dynamics, wit and humor, charm and charisma, and are pretty faithful to their gaming counterparts while also improving on some of them, like the good-natured Mario, the more nervous Luigi, the stern and fiery Peach, who does act more like a legit leader in this as opposed to the typical damsel, the spunky Toad, the brawny Donkey Kong and his father Cranky, the awkward Kamek, and throughout the movie there are some neat cameos from some other Mario and Donkey Kong characters, like Pauline, Diddy Kong, and Dixie Kong. As for Bowser, not only is he a very fun and bombastic villain who does have some funny moments, but he can also be legitimately menacing and intimidating. The voice acting is very well done, as the voice actors do all manage to deliver some pretty solid performances, like Chris Pratt as Mario, Charlie Day as Luigi, Anya Taylor-Joy as Peach, Jack Black as Bowser, Keegan-Michael Key as Toad, Seth Rogen as Donkey Kong, Fred Armisen as Cranky, Kevin Michael Richardson as Kamek, and more, including a couple of neat voice cameos from Charles Martinet, the guy who voiced both Mario and Luigi in the games from 1991 to 2023. The music by Brian Tyler is very well done, as his score does sound very nice and well composed. And it really does manage to capture the movie's adventurous, fantastical, comedic, charming, and light-hearted tone. Also, Tyler does implement certain music themes from the games into the movie very well. So, for my final verdict on this Universal and Illumination movie, I'm giving it an 11 out of 10. This movie was like an amazing movie made in 2023, having a movie of another video game franchise. And that concludes today's episode of my movie review series. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button and the subscribe button. And don't forget to hit the bell for notifications. And let me know in the comments below in which movie I'm going to do next. Enjoy your day.